one of the most agonizing difficulties commonly faced by the forex risk manager is not knowing where the market is likely to go. This makes it nearly impossible for him to decide whether to hedge or not to hedge. To put an end to his indecision and not knowing what to do, he often leaves the exposure unhedged. He thinks, who knows whether taking a hedge will be right or wrong? It is better not to do anything. Who will take the blame if things go wrong? The strategy of inaction works well enough if the market is either stable or is moving in favor of the exposure. Unfortunately, the happy state of affairs does not last forever, and the risk manager often ends up hedging in a state of panic when the market starts to go against him. The whole hedging process is filled with tension. This is due to two misconceptions. The first misconception is that the risk manager has to necessarily hedge at the highest rates for exports and at the lowest rates for imports. And the second misconception is that when he hedges, he should hedge 100% of the exposure. However, the seasoned risk manager knows that it is not possible to strike the tops and bottoms of the market. The simple trick he employs is to hedge the exposure in parts instead of as a whole. He breaks up the exposure into 3 parts or 4 parts or even 10 to 12 parts. And then proceeds to hedge each part at different rates and at different times in the market. Since the hedges are taken at regular intervals over time, the risk manager is able to achieve a decent average rate. Does not have to worry about trying to achieve the highest or lowest rates. Or in other words, he does not have to try and time the market. Even if a couple of forecasts on which the hedges are based go wrong, it is not a big worry because 1. The wrong forecast does not impact the entire hedge, and 2. There are good chances that subsequent forecasts will go right. This dramatically reduces the arbitrariness and ad hocism in the hedging process and greatly enhances the systematic aspect of hedging. All of the above together make the whole hedging process much more robust than if each exposure were to be hedged in one go. It has been our experience that in the hands of a skilled risk manager, this simple strategy of hedging in parts can go far to help a company achieve an average realization rate that is sometimes better than the average market rate also. So remember, do not leave your exposure totally unhedged and do not cover it fully in one go. Try and hedge in parts. Thank you.